Have you ever wondered how Starbucks became the titan of coffee it is today? Well, let's take a trip down memory lane to the year 1971. Tucked away in Seattle's Pike Place Market, a single store sprang to life, the brainchild of three friends: Jerry Baldwin, Zev Siegl, and Gordon Bowker. Their mission wasn't to serve up steaming cups of cappuccinos or lattes, but rather to provide high-quality coffee beans and equipment to those who wanted to brew their own at home. Starbucks, named after the first mate in Herman Melville's Moby Dick, was a beacon for coffee lovers, a place where one could find the finest beans from Africa, Central and Latin America, and Asia-Pacific regions. The founders, Baldwin, Siegl and Bowker, were coffee connoisseurs in their own right. They didn't just sell coffee, they lived it, breathed it, and most importantly, they loved it. This love for coffee translated into their business. They aimed at providing a unique coffee experience to their customers. The focus was on quality, not quantity. It wasn't about churning out the maximum number of cups per day. Instead, it was about ensuring that each bean sold in their store was of the highest quality, sourced from the best places. The trio, with their extensive knowledge about coffee, also sold equipment to brew the perfect cup at home. They didn't just want to sell beans. They wanted their customers to experience the joy and satisfaction of brewing a perfect cup of coffee themselves. Yet, this was just the beginning. A small store in a corner of Pike Place Market was about to embark on a journey that would see it transform into a global phenomenon. The Starbucks we know today, with its green mermaid logo gracing streets in cities around the world, was still a long way off. Yes, the Starbucks we know today, with its ubiquitous presence and signature drinks, was still a long way off. The transformation began with a man named Howard Schultz. This dynamic individual, who would later become the driving force behind Starbucks' success, was not just a businessman. He was a visionary, a dreamer, and most importantly, a lover of coffee. In the year 1983, Schultz embarked on a trip to Italy. It was in the sun-drenched piazzas of Milan that he discovered something more than just the deep, rich aroma of espresso. He found a culture, a tradition, and a way of life. The espresso bars of Italy were more than just places to grab a quick cup of joe. They were social hubs, community centers, places where people gathered to chat, debate, and share the joys and troubles of everyday life. Schultz was captivated. He saw in these Italian coffee houses something that was missing in the United States: a sense of community, of connection, of conviviality. He dreamt of bringing this Italian tradition back to America. He envisioned coffee shops not just as places to buy coffee, but as a third place between work and home, where people could relax, meet friends, and feel a sense of belonging. However, not everyone shared Schultz's vision. The founders of Starbucks, who had hired Schultz as their director of retail operations and marketing, were hesitant. They wanted to focus on selling coffee beans and equipment, not on creating a cafe culture. This disagreement led to a parting of ways. Undeterred, Schultz set out on his own. He started a new company, Il Giornale, which was dedicated to the concept of the Italian coffee house. The venture was a success, proving that Schultz's vision was not just a pipe dream, but a viable business model. But the story of Starbucks does not end here. In fact, it's just beginning. The next chapter would see Schultz's vision take flight in a way that would change the coffee landscape in the United States and the world forever. In 1987, a crucial turning point came in the Starbucks story. This was the year that Howard Schultz, a man who had been captivated by the potential of Starbucks, decided to take his vision to the next level. He purchased Starbucks from its original founders, combining it with his own burgeoning company, Il Giornale. This merger would mark the beginning of a new era for Starbucks, an era of exponential growth and global recognition. Schultz, having been inspired by the coffee culture in Italy, wanted to recreate that experience in America. He was not just selling coffee, he was selling an experience, a sense of community. Under his leadership, Starbucks transformed from a humble local coffee shop into a beacon for coffee lovers worldwide. The 1990s witnessed the rise of Starbucks as a global powerhouse. With a clear vision and a strong business model, Starbucks began an aggressive expansion. It was during this period that Starbucks was opening, on average, 2 new stores every day. Yes, you heard it right, every single day. This rapid expansion was not just limited to the United States. Starbucks was spreading its wings across the globe, marking its presence in countries far and wide. This was not just about the numbers. Each new Starbucks store was a new community, a new experience. Every store was a place where people could come together, share a cup of coffee, and feel a sense of belonging. Starbucks was not just selling coffee, it was selling a lifestyle, a culture. It was creating a global coffee culture, one store at a time. The Starbucks experience, the quality of their coffee, and the sense of community they fostered had people coming back for more. The Starbucks logo became a symbol of quality, comfort, and community. It was a symbol that was recognized and loved across the globe. By the end of the 90s, Starbucks had become more than a coffee shop. It was a global phenomenon, a symbol of a lifestyle, a community, a culture. Starbucks had etched its name in the annals of business history, and there was no looking back. Starbucks was now not just a coffee shop, but a global phenomenon. Starbucks, however, did not stop at just selling coffee. No, it dared to venture beyond the confines of mere coffee beans and brewing. The company's innovative spirit led it to explore new territories, to diversify. And so, Starbucks began to create a unique, immersive experience that went beyond the cup. Imagine walking into a Starbucks, the aroma of freshly brewed coffee enveloping you. But what's that you hear? It's the melodic strains of the newest indie band playing softly in the background, a CD of which you can conveniently purchase right there. Yes, Starbucks dabbled in the music industry, becoming a platform for both established artists and upcoming talent. They even dipped their toes into the world of film and books, curating a selection that resonated with their brand image and consumer tastes. However, Starbucks didn't just stop at enhancing the customer experience. They took a step further, embracing a commitment to ethical sourcing and environmental stewardship. They made it their mission to ensure that every cup of coffee they sold was responsibly sourced, promoting fair trade and sustainability. They partnered with farmers across the globe, ensuring they received a fair price for their beans, and invested in farming practices that protected the environment. Their stores became a testament to their commitment to sustainability. With innovative green designs and energy-saving practices, they sought to reduce their carbon footprint. They strive to create a positive impact not just on their customers' lives, but on the world at large. This diversification and commitment to ethical practices played a significant role in shaping Starbucks' brand image. It wasn't just about coffee anymore. It was about music, film, books, and most importantly, it was about making a positive impact. It was about creating an experience, a lifestyle. Starbucks was now more than a coffee company. It was a part of daily life for millions around the world. It was a place where people came not just for the coffee, but for the atmosphere, for the experience, for the sense of community. Starbucks had truly gone beyond coffee. So what's the secret behind Starbucks' success, you might ask? Well, it's not as simple as brewing a good cup of joe. It's an intricate blend of ingredients that have been carefully chosen and meticulously mixed. First and foremost, Starbucks had a clear vision. From the outset, they knew they wanted to be more than just a coffee shop. They envisioned a place where people could gather, a sort of third place between home and work. This clear vision guided their every decision, from the design of their stores to the way they trained their baristas. Next, they embarked on a strategy of rapid expansion. Starbucks was not content with being a local success story. They wanted to take their unique blend of coffee and community to the world. And they didn't just open stores, they created experiences, each one a little oasis of comfort and familiarity in a bustling city or sleepy suburb. But Starbucks didn't just stop at coffee. They diversified, introducing a range of food items, selling merchandise, and even launching a music label. This not only boosted their revenue, but also helped to make Starbucks a part of their customers' daily lives, beyond the morning caffeine fix. And let's not forget their commitment to social responsibility. From ethically sourced coffee to community initiatives, Starbucks has always strived to do business in a way that's good for the world. This commitment has earned them a loyal customer base that values not just what Starbucks sells, but what it stands for. However, the real secret ingredient, the one that sets Starbucks apart, is its focus on the customer experience. From the moment you walk into a Starbucks store, you're enveloped in a warm, inviting ambience. The product quality is consistent, the service is friendly, and the atmosphere is just right. It's this experience, this feeling of being a part of something special, that keeps customers coming back for more. Starbucks' story is a testament to the power of a clear vision, relentless execution, and the ability to adapt, making it the coffee empire we know today. It's a story of success brewed to perfection, one cup at a time.